main character is a social worker, a child protective services investigator, who works in the logging towns of northwestern Montana, where I grew up. He's an interesting character because he's been doing this job for a little while, and he's the people that he works with don't really like the government very much. It's a place that's fiercely individualistic, and the people who live up there don't want the government, and they definitely don't want the government coming and knocking on their doors and asking about their kids. But driven by his compassion for children, the main character, Pete Snow, is compelled to help the kids. One day, a young boy shows up at a school, and no one knows where he's from. He appears to be malnourished. He doesn't look like he's necessarily been abused, but he's definitely been neglected and been living in the woods. And so Pete takes him out for some lunch and buys him some clothes and tries to find out a little bit about him, and finds out that the kid's living in the woods with his father and his mother and the rest of his family. And so Pete offers to take him back to his family. And when he gets out there, the boy's father comes out of the wilderness with shoots his rifle off. It's at night. He's got a big bright light that he shines in Pete's face and knocks him on the ground and makes the kid take off the clothes that Pete bought for him. It's cold winter, almost winter, and Pete says, "You know, I'm not a bad guy. I'm just here to help." And the father insists that the kid take off all the clothes, and Pete says, "I wouldn't have brought him back if I thought you were going to make him go in the woods naked." And the guy says, "I'd kill him before I'd let you have him." And that's the first time that Pete sort of realizes that this guy he's dealing with is pretty crazy. As it turns out, the man's name is Jeremiah Pearl, and he's known in the region for being a bit of a survivalist, bit of a troublemaker who's ready for the end of the world. And so with a bit of courage and caution, Pete begins to try and earn their trust and get them to step back from the brink. But obviously there are complications along the way. Not least of which is Pete's own family, which is falling apart. So you kind of have this irony where there's a guy who's really good at helping other people's families, but not so good at taking care of his own. I think there's this phrase that I'm sure, I'm guessing people are aware of, you know, the great American novel, which I always thought was kind of a weird thing because America is such a diverse country. Who could possibly write the one great American novel? Even if you had a different great American novel every year, someone would feel left out, you know? I think that America's, that idea had always come from a sort of American anxiety when it was a young country, and it was like, where's our Madame Bovary? You know, where's our Anna Karenina? Where's our great American novel? A couple hundred years in, I think we've written a lot of great novels coming from a lot of different places. And I think right now the motivation for most Americans is actually almost to write something very specific about a very specific part of America. Everybody's sort of exploring and sharing their piece of America. So I think the motivation is to kind of get at those nooks and crannies of the culture that don't normally get a lot of attention. I know that was what drove me to write my novel. And you see it in a lot of other, you know, great American novels.